Hi, I'm Nita Strauss, and we're hanging out here at my home studio that we built together with GC Pro. And today I'm going to show you how I can quickly and easily audition multiple guitar sounds within one session. So right now I have this guitar plugged into my interface right here. And from there, the signal is sending out to my Rocktron Prophesy preamp, to my Kemper here in the rack. I have a clean DI coming into the Pro Tools session for using different plugins, and I'm also sending it out to a radial DI box so we can reamp with a live amp in the room. So first things first, this Rocktron Prophesy here in the rack over to the side is actually the original unit that I've had, I think, since 2008. And even some of my Kemper profiles are based on these sounds because I just spent like 10 years developing them and just fine tuning them. It is a very well-loved unit. You can see there are missing buttons and labels and the back is a mess, but this is my original one that I've had forever. But this is my trusty rhythm patch and it sounds like this. So even though this is older technology, you know, 15 years old, I can still bring it into my super modern studio and it sounds just as great as it always did. So next up we have the Kemper, obviously a piece of gear that a lot of people are familiar with. My own working Kemper is actually out on the road with the Alice Cooper gear. So here in the studio, this is actually my boyfriend Josh's Kemper. So I just grabbed a Friedman Brown Eye from his sounds just to show you guys what the Kemper sounds like and how you can work it into this signal chain. One of the ways that I use Pro Tools most often is just to plug my guitar into the interface and pull up a quick plugin that sounds great, that is good enough for me to use for whatever idea I need to get out at the time. And 9 times out of 10, what I use is the Toontrack EZMix plugins. This is something that I have installed on my laptop as well, so I can just put my headphones on, set my arrow up on a hotel desk, and get the same sound that I have at my studio at home. So this tone that I have dialed up here is called Addictive. It's part of the Andy Sneap plugin suite. I have 3 go-to sounds actually that I cycle between, and they're all part of the Andy Sneap preset pack, including the Summer Storm ones that you guys may have heard. So this one is called Addictive and it sounds like this. So of course, there are some days that you just want to use your favorite amp. And while my favorite Marshall amps are still out on the road with the Alice Cooper gear, and I do miss them dearly, we still want to show you guys how you could run your favorite amp into a setup like this. So we are using my Bogner that we have here in the studio. It is a custom-built Bogner Uberschall that was modded for me by Reinhold Bogner himself, which is a very, very cool little piece of music history for me to own. And we're running this into a radial DI box into the Bogner cabinet, which is in my ISO booth. But if you don't have a closet in your house that you're willing to sacrifice to make an ISO booth out of, you can still run the same kind of setup. You can use a 2-notes torpedo, you can use a UA aux, you can use basically any reactive load box that works for you and your budget to make sure that you can get your favorite tube amp directly into your session without waking up your neighbors. We're doing something pretty cool with our live amp setup today. We have the Bogner head and cab, and on the cab, we have a Slate ML-2 mic. So the Slate mics are modeling mics, which means they sound great by themselves as standalone mics, but you can also open up the Slate plugin and audition all kinds of different mics to get the exact sound that you want. So right now in my session, we are using a classic ribbon mic model. Let me pull that up for you. This is what it looks like. And then as I'm playing right now, I'll start on the 121 and then I'll cycle through a couple different mic models so you can see the difference and how easy it is to try it out for yourself. So obviously that last one is an example of why you should not put a kick mic on a guitar cab, but it really is also a great example of why we chose the Slate mics for the studio, because we didn't want to have to buy dozens and dozens of mics that would just have one application here and there. We just wanted one set of mics that we could use for any need that we have. One important thing to keep in mind with a setup like this is that you actually don't have to nail your tone right away. You just have to nail a good take. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna switch guitars to a drop C guitar, I'm gonna play along to one of my songs, and I'm gonna show you guys how we take that clean DI and reamp it to find the tone that we want. So I'm on my hardtail now. I switched this guitar just because it was a little easier to put in drop C than the Jivas with the double locking bridge. But what we're gonna do right now is take a riff of Summer Storm and take one pass of it. We're gonna record all the outputs just for fun, and then we will take the clean DI and do a little reamping. So now that we have that clean DI take, you can see that we can audition tons of different plugins on the fly really easily until we find a sound that we like. So I will loop this for you. First, you'll hear the clean DI sound, and then we'll audition some different tones to show you how fast it is. As you can see, it couldn't possibly be simpler to change out your different sounds once you have a take that you like. And finally, for those days that you just want to use your favorite amp, we are going to take that same DI that you just heard. We're going to record it once through the reamp with the 121. And then once it's recorded, we'll cycle through some of the different Slate mics so you can see how easy that is. So we've got our recording, now let's try a few different mics. So as you can see, there are so many different things you can do with this setup. We have barely scratched the surface. So the one piece of advice I want to leave you with is try this out at home, grab some of these plugins, be fearless and be creative, and above all, have a great time with it.